going on, YouTube? Got a little update here for the hot tub aquaponic garden. As you can see, quite thinned out. You see these strawberries here. I thinned the heck out of them. Some of them, like this guy right here, does not look like he's going to make it. Other ones, like this one, can I see? You can kind of see the little white dots there all over it. Not sure if that guy's going to make it, but I thinned him down pretty good. These guys, yeah, everybody. This guy didn't make it at all. This guy does not look like it's going to make it at all. A bunch of white dots all over him. Little runner there I didn't get rid of. Oh, dead freaking spider. That's neat. and a bunch of these runners I pulled. I got them right over here. I'm going to go ahead and try to see if they can grow. But a bunch of them, like say this one, you see little white dots all over them. I'm really not sure if I want to spread this crap all around the greenhouse. So maybe when I'm done shooting here, I'm just going to throw them out. Anyway, let's get on with the tour here. Everything's looking pretty half decent. got a bunch of garbage like this, some damaged leaves, and they're kind of discolored and everything. But the newer growth here, as you move up, jalapeno, is looking a little better. One thing I did want to do is check out the size of this freaking carrot. So that answers the question of whether you can grow carrots in an aquaponic garden. And up, that was all the bigger it really was. But not too bad. Not really a bottom part to it. But hey, I grew some carrots. Go ahead and pull the other guy. Looking half decent. Not bad there. And one more. Yeah, a little double bunch looking thing there. Alright. Now it's all wrapped up in my strawberry runners and everything, so I'll have to take care of that as soon as I'm done here. It's all wrapped around this freaking Cajun bell back there. As you can see, I've got a few nice little fruit on there. Looking nice. Some yellowing of the leaves, some leaves dropping off. But lots and lots of fruit trying to come on there, so that's kind of encouraging. Right here next to it, my mucho nacho. Let's move these guys out of the way. As you can see, I got a broken branch right there on the top. Ah, it was a big part too. Oh well, looks like this plant is topped, kind of. But anyway, I got a couple on there, looking half decent. These guys right here, jalapeno, looking nice. Another one right over here, bunch of fruit starting to form right up here. Looking good. My garlic down here, I've been forgetting about this guy. He's still kind of growing, maybe. Not anymore. Oh well. In the middle of, here's my Lorraine strawberry. Nice little pretty little guy. Looking half decent. This right here is one of the ones when I was pulling out dead leaves and everything, it just kind of came out. Whoops. So I guess I kind of killed that one. We'll just go ahead and ditch that and forget that one even happened. Let me see here. My lettuce is starting to seed, which is very encouraging. It's lettuce time. Well, time to plant lettuce anyways. And I'm hoping some of this falls right into the bed. It's kind of hanging off of the bed here, like kind of this way a little bit. But oh well, we'll just keep moving it around. Once I get rid of some of the stuff over there, I think I'm going to try to coax them that way, see if they'll make it. Right here, my Carmen. Look at this, man. Got all kind of nice growth. Nice little pepper here. Gigantic pepper over here. Nice. And we even have more. A little curly Q. Look, more up here. I mean, they're everywhere. And, oh, I'm sorry. These are my cowhorn. No wonder they're so freaking long. And look, I've got more over there, right there. They're just everywhere. But they're so heavy, they're leaning onto my Carmen, which there's only one. My bad. Holy crap, that thing's really leaning. Okay, so we need a trellis over here. Alrighty, mammoth jalapeno here. Got a nice one right there. Two more right here. Looking beautiful. Nice fork right there. Alright. Over here in the corner, my beautiful jalapeno. Look how beautiful this thing is. I'm so proud of this guy. Looking so nice. Couple more peppers popping right on here. Another one. Hey, leaf in the way. Hello. There we go. Another one right there. They're all over the place. Well, not really all over the place, but like right here. But there's a few on there. Looking pretty nice. My lunchbox orange still only has one. Leaves are kind of yellowed. Another green bell right here, or maybe, no, this is another jalapeno right here. Little pepper nodes popping off, so hopefully we get some. Green bell, nice one there, little one there, like redding one there. So guess I should have picked that one already. Didn't look right, but anyway, must have been. Oh, forgot all about my watermelon fail here. This guy is just getting crappier and crappier every week. Cantaloupe is actually loving it, so I'm actually training this thing all along here. Got a bunch of flowers on there, so hopefully we can get some cantaloupe out of there. And in case you were wondering, whenever they do start fruiting and start forming, I was figuring that I would get some kind of, I don't know, like a sack or like some kind of netting or something like that, and just kind of screw it onto the side to suspend it. That way it's not weighing down on the plant or anything like that. I'm actually thinking that far ahead. We gotta actually see fruit forming to put that in action, but whatever. This kale, oh my god. This thing wins plant of the week. Holy crap, look at the size of this trunk. I mean, oh, dirty freaking hands. Look at the size of this trunk. It is gigantic, man. I've been trimming it back. You can see, nice and big. It's kind of leaning on my little grasshopper here. But it is gigantic with tons of new growth coming right out. So I've just been trimming the heck out of it no matter what. Whether I have to give it to the chickens or I'm taking it into work and giving it to some of my foreign friends or what. Whatever, man. Like, I am just regularly trimming this guy as well as this one right behind it. Looking pretty decent. My Swiss chard right behind it. Kind of spindly looking, but hey, it's coming right along. Moving right along, we've got... what was that? Another one of the Lorange strawberries, I believe. And it had a runner, and I just planted it right next to it. A little bit of algae forming here on the intakes. I'm trying to figure out a better way for a water intake into these beds. Whenever you get to, say, like right over here, look at the root mass there. And you can see where the pipe used to be. The roots just want to go straight for the water pipes. And I hate how everybody else does it, where they just have like right here, and it just kind of like falls into the bed. Because then you get this algae growth right here. And that's what I've been trying to avoid the entire time. That's why these pipes are going into the bed. But as you can see, you get roots backing it up and it has to come out. And then algae starts forming again. So I don't know. It's kind of a double-edged sword. Unless you could figure out a way to do it like dead center in the middle of the bed. Keep like right in the middle, say strawberries or some small rooting crops or something like that. But even if you did that, the tomatoes on the perimeter there would probably just, all the roots would migrate towards the intake. And that would be if it was on the completely bottom there, like have a pipe go down in there and then underneath. And then, I don't know, that might be a way to do it. Maybe just put a pipe or two pipes actually, one on each side or maybe even three, and then run it the entire length of the bed, drill holes in the side of it and everything, and then wrap screen around it so the roots can't get in. That might be an idea. Maybe I'll attempt that next time I make a new bed here, which, who knows, maybe I'll do that soon. Rambling. All right, yellow cherry, standing up nice and tall, been flicking it. Got a little bit of flowers up there. Been flicking it, talking nice to it, you know, buying it things, telling how pretty it looks, you're so pretty, and stroking it and all that fun stuff. My better boy over here, looking okay. Actually looking better than most of the tomatoes, but no fruit on it yet. Radicchio over there is actually still flowering a little bit. I can't see if you're seeing what I'm looking at, but close enough, it's flowering over there. My jalapeno, one little jalapeno on there, but it's looking pretty decent. My shishito, I took one off of it. I still have one more on it, and it's kind of weighing down the plant a little bit. Probably need to get some kind of trellis type thing designed. I've got more strawberries back there. I've thinned them out as well, trying to, and replanted some runners, and they're going to get cut soon. My dragon cayennes, a few of them nice and ripe that need to be picked. A couple more right behind it, jalapenos beside it, and banana peppers way back there in the back. Some more of my strawberries right here, runners and stuff like that. Everything's looking good. Nice little kale. Look at this sucker, man. For a little kale, this is nice. It's going to be gigantic very soon. I'm going to keep trimming it, and it's going to keep growing. I'm really surprised this stuff is still growing in the middle of July, or end of July. Oh my God, like Saturday will be, I think it's Saturday, will be August. So, I mean, for crying out loud, this is crazy. I never knew that kale could do that. By the way, Swiss chard there, looking gigantic, massive. Been trimming that back as well. That was it from this bed. Oh, I guess this kale right here, this other gigantic freaking thing, that also is in this bed. Nice freaking stem on that thing. Gigantic. My couple of my strawberries. I always mess them up. Strawberries and tomatoes. I call that each of them the wrong name. But these guys up here, that's a nice little, I don't know, that's not, that's a, no, I guess that would be a whole sucker right there. Giant sucker. I haven't been cutting my suckers this year. I've been kind of letting them do their thing, but I'm going to cut a few, and that way I can go ahead and have a few extra plants, because hopefully, last year I made it, halfway into January, and I was still growing tomatoes here, and they were actually producing and everything like that, and the aphids came, and I really didn't know. All you had to do was buy some freaking ladybugs. 1500, bam, they attack everything, and you can keep on growing. I pulled all the tomatoes. Man, I always screw those two up, tomatoes and strawberries, but I had to pull all of them, and that was the middle of January. I probably could have made it into close to the middle of February, so that's what I'm shooting for this year, and that's why I got a couple suckers here like that. That little guy really hasn't been doing much, just like these, freak peppers. Couldn't remember. But this guy is starting to put off growth. This is the one I'm worried about. He just dropped all his leaves. But I seem to have that as a theme with a bunch of the peppers. I'll show you more about that in a second. Nice little jalapeno here. Nice. Right here on this semi-decent little plant here. He's quickly becoming my second favorite right here. And yeah. This little guy right back here. Here's another one. Crappy looking fruit. All the leaves are just dying right off it. Look, leaves falling off while I'm recording it. Yay. Not exactly sure what's going on with that guy, but he's got some growth at the bottom. Maybe that'll make up for it. This little sucker. Hey, all the way up here, and it's flowering. Give it a little flick here. Flick, 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 flick. Make me some food. Another one right here, indigo rose, nice little fruit right there, and flicking this little sucker in that one. Anyway, yeah, I'm using myself here. Little tiny carrots here, not really expecting anything out of these guys. Oh man, look at that. They're hidden right in there. Freaking grasshopper. What the heck? You're really gonna do that to me right in the middle of freaking filming? Cool. Okay, he's dead. And look, there's a, I guess that would be a molt of one of them. And if I can get all this crap out of the way here. There we go. You see like a molt of the grasshopper. If you don't know, that means they outgrow their skin and they pretty much come out of their skin. Here's a, and that's right on one of my kale here, looking beautiful with some grasshopper damage. And some more right here. But anyway, there's another kale right here. More carrots right there. Swiss chard, kind of looking crappy when you think about the one that's over there, because that one's way better. But yeah, these guys were real young. But and I grew these from seed. Thank you, JT Bear. But they're coming right along. A little bit kind of looking crappy and everything, but we got all kind of weird things going on right now, especially with these strawberries. Look, dead, dead. Dead, 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 kind of living. And then we got some more, like this one looking kind of crappy. I don't really trim that one back much, that one, these guys. This one I thought was hilarious because, look, we've got like a little, what is this, not a maple, but some sort of tree here growing right out of it. And I kept that in there just for this recording, so, but I'm going to pull that in a second. Back over here, what else do we have left? I guess just this barker's hot, and it's really producing a bunch of peppers here, up here, some more over here. But, like I said, look, leaves Some of them are just crappy, starting to fall right off and everything. Some of them are just kind of, I don't know, lacking. I don't know. We'll just move on and see what happens. Right over there, you see my Mexi Bell. Actually, you can see a little bit of pest poop or whatever right on there. So maybe I'm starting to get a couple clues here as to what's going on. But, and then you've got my Roma tomato here, which I thought I had aroma on there. No, but there's a bunch of flowers right up there at the top. Step over here, turn up my reservoir pump, which was, my reservoir pump here, which actually I could probably get another gallon or so out of that thing, tilt it up on its side, and it runs right in here into the fish tank here. And as you can see, the ledge is just barely covered there, maybe half inch or so. I got a fish over there next to that net that doesn't seem to be doing anything. I had a few fish die off this week. No big deal. But one of the things that is big deal is this right here. As you can see, it's just here. And you can see it's just dribbling a little bit. I've been having a little bit of problem with the plumbing. I'll show you that in a second. As soon as I get over there, the heck is this? My purple basil. That's right, because it's not purple right now. Purple basil here, kind of looking good, flowering all over and everything, looking half decent. A bunch of shoots popping up like this, starting like new growth and everything. Red bell over here, looking half decent. My habanero is looking very nice, starting to branch out and everything. Right over there, got more right here with a little ladybug on it. And another one right here. There's the only two right now. Leaves falling off again. There's another leaf right here. What the hell is going on? But yeah, like I said, some of the peppers, the leaves just falling off. Another watermelon right here. Kind of stalled, got that big, and just really didn't do much of anything else. So jalapeno, looking pretty nice. Got one right there. Another one right over there. Maybe one right there. But nice little fork right there. Love that. My poblano, looking pretty good. Got a pepper right there. But the leaves are looking pretty good. Little spider type dealy right there. In the background there, my green bell. Oh, there's my one of my praying mantis friends right there. Hanging out at the bottom of the green bell, which is not really green. It's kind of reddish. So I'm thinking I probably should have picked that one already. My jalapeno. It's not a jalapeno. I kind of remembered what it is. This is a banana pepper. I can't remember if it's sweet or hot, but it's a banana pepper, and I'm willing to bet this little guy right here behind it is banana as well, but this one I believe is a jalapeno. I can't see inside there to see if it's yellow or green, but I'm kind of thinking it's a jalapeno. See, don't think I forgot anything. My massive root mass over here, you can see this was up in the pipe before, kind of hanging over now. I've been monitoring it, making sure nothing is getting in, but as you can see, it's really not getting water in. I'll show you the plumbing fail. Part of it is this shutoff right over here, which as you can see is wide open. These tomatoes, not strawberries, are gigantic. They are way up there. They're not really to the roof yet. They look like they've got maybe a foot to go, and that's almost 10 feet where the roof is, so not too bad. My Malabar spinach, looking daggone good. Real nice and tall and everything. Alright, well, the plumbing issue. As you can see, this is my main line coming in here, and it goes off to the hydro tube right here. This is my shutoff, which shouldn't be there. It should come to the T, come over here, and then have a shutoff, which this side doesn't. The other side does. That's part of my problem right there. Then I could regulate how much each side gets, because the more I try to adjust that, the more this bed gets, and that one over there really isn't getting much. Anyway, over here, my strawberries. Look at this thing. It was a whole bunch of strawberries, and there were leaves everywhere. I went through and I took out everything on this thing. All the dead leaves and stuff, everything with little tips like this, the little red rust tip looks like this. And if you don't have strawberries, they kind of peel off like this. And as you can see, they just kind of like peel right off. But you have to be very careful with it. you don't want to just yank on it and everything, especially with aquaponics and they're in the rocks and stuff. So you kind of want to hold the plant and then peel this stuff off. But just to give you a little idea of how many leaves I took off of this area between the hydro tube and this one bed, all these leaves were today that I took off just from here and from the hydro tube. So I've been decimating the strawberries here, but my theory is, hey, they, well, first off, they need leaves trimmed off from time to time because the leaves die. But besides that, I'm just trying to do something with these guys, and a lot of them are dying, like this guy right over here and that guy right over there and there. I can just keep going on, but yeah, anyway, so yeah, just been trying to make these strawberries live by kind of taking out some of them. See if that works. Everything's always an experiment over here, but I'm loving how high the water level is right now. Looking pretty good. I had three or four goldfish die off out of, what, two or three dozen, so that's not that bad. Got a few more, 13 throw in there. I guess I'll tell you about that later. That's a whole different story. But yeah, so this is everything I got going on, my gigantic mess I need to clean up or leave there or whatever. Right over here on the seed starting table, I've got mystery plant right here. Kind of looks like basil, maybe, something like that. Not sure. This thing, I don't even know what's going on with that. It looks goofy, and it's probably going to die. My freak hot peppers, they are, I don't know, they seem like they're stunted. They're just not really doing anything. It looks kind of dry in here. It's actually kind of moist. I've been keeping track of that. I've been letting them dry out a little bit. And, which is the problem with these peat pods, they dry out way quicker than these peat cups. And my reapers right here, 1 and 2. Kind of crappy germination rate. I put in 6 and I got 2, so that's like 33%. But as you can see, this guy looks kind of nice. This one looks really, really small and weird. So, I don't know. Not very good germination rate on these guys, but I don't know, might just be them, might be me, who knows. But yeah, so all kind of fun stuff here. That's what's been going on around here. Nice wall of tomatoes over there, love that. But yeah, I actually had a couple minutes to do a little bit of stuff around here, so I did it, and that's what I got going on. Hey, look at that nice little predatory wasp right there hanging out. These guys are not my you made me flinch. They are not fans of me. It seems like every time they're hanging somewhere, I seem to be messing with it. And then they, like, kind of swarm me and try to hit me in the face with their body and stuff like that. But haven't stung me yet, so hope they don't. But, yeah, another look at my crappy-looking peppers over there. Ugh. Man, that's harsh. I've also been leaving the door open. And over there, this left window, I've been pulled out all the screen and rolled it up. It's that dark thing at the very top up there. So now we are just free to come in and out, any kind of insects and stuff like that, pollinate and take care of stuff like that. Anyway, that's been a long extended ramble of a walk around update type video. So don't forget to like, favorite, subscribe, leave a comment down below, all that fun happy media stuff, and I will catch you next time. But until then, later.